So let's see how depreciation and income taxes fit together with capital budgeting. Don't worry, it's not too bad. You don't have to hide under the couch. It's pretty straightforward once you get the idea. So we bought a car for our business. You're an Uber driver and you buy that $50,000 sports car and you think you'll make a little extra money because it's purple and everybody will be able to pick you out of a crowd. You think you'll sell it in 3 years for 20 and it will generate 15,000 in revenue and you have a 30% tax rate. So what effect does this purchase have on your income statement? On your income statement, besides the revenue and the $15,000, you also have depreciation expense of $10,000. So that's going to show up on your income statement. But the question is that a cash flow? And hopefully you said, no, it's not, because really when I pay for the car of $50,000 today, that's my cash flow. And I get back $20,000 at the end, that's a cash flow. But the depreciation doesn't cost me anything. That's just expensing the amount over the period of time I'm using it to do matching for my income statement, but it's not a cash flow. So thinking back, for capital budgeting, it always says to use your future cash flows. So that means depreciation expense, which is a non-cash item, those are not included. If a problem happens to start you out with net income, you're going to have to back out those non-cash items. So add back the depreciation because that really didn't use up any cash. The cash flows or the fixed assets occur when you buy or sell the asset. So if you showed a cash flow when you buy the asset and you had depreciation, you'd be double counting because it really only cost you $50,000 for the car, not any more or less than that. Besides depreciation, there's some other non-cash items. So you have depreciation on your fixed assets. On intangibles, we call it amortization. It's the same thing, it's just a fancier name. So amortization expense on any intangibles. And then we also have gains and losses on the fixed assets or the intangibles. Those are also non-cash. Again, when I sell the car, I sell it for $20,000 and get $20,000 cash, no matter what my book value is. And a gain or loss really only occurs because if I didn't depreciate it exactly the same way, based on the salvage value that I really truly get, I'd end up with a gain or a loss. So you only have a gain or a loss because you didn't exactly estimate the salvage value correctly. So when we get to depreciation and income taxes, remember those income taxes are a percentage of taxable income. And the important part is depreciation is deductible for income taxes. So depreciation ends up saving you taxes even though it's a non-cash flow. So again, depreciation is never a cash flow, but you do get some tax savings, and those tax savings are a cash flow. And sometimes we call it a depreciation tax shield. So let's go back to that initial example where we bought our $50,000 sports car and we think we'll generate revenues of $15,000 per year. So if we look at our income statement, our revenues will increase by $15,000. And if we didn't have anything else going on, we'd have to pay 30% of that in taxes. However, we get to reduce that by our depreciation expense. And we'll assume here we get $10,000 for both book and taxes. So before taxes, we've got $5,000 of taxable income. Our tax rate's 30%. So our taxes are only $1,500. Rather than that 30% of $15,000. So that means for cash flows, We've got that $15,000 of cash flows from the amount we collect from our customers, and we have to pay only $1,500 in taxes out of that. So our net cash flows really are $13,500. Rather than working through the tax return and the cash flows, the shortcut is to put together what we did in the last video. So our net cash flows are $15,000 times 1 minus the tax rate, or $70,000, which means that we would get to keep $10,500 of that. But we also get to save in taxes, and that's where the depreciation comes in. You've got $10,000 in depreciation, and 30% of that is what you save in your taxes. So you've got $3,000 savings. So the net cash flow ends up with that same $13,500. So putting it all together, depreciation expense is a non-cash flow. However, it does impact the taxes you paid, so you'll have some tax savings. But again, depreciation expense is non-cash. So the net cash flow ends up being the cash flows after taxes from your revenues and expenses on your project. And then you add the tax savings that you get due to depreciation. So let's put it all together and see if we really can buy our sports car. We purchased the car today, so that's our cash outflow of $50,000. We have after-tax cash flows of $10,500 each year, and that's the 70% of the $15,000. Then we have $3,000 in tax savings. That's the 30% of our $10,000 depreciation every year. And then finally, we sell the car at the end, so we get another $20,000 from selling the car. So if we total those up and take them times the present value factor, I'm assuming 5%, we end up with a total cash flows of $55,041. Our cash outflow was $50,000, so we end up with a positive present value of $5,041, so we can go out and buy that pretty purple sports car with a clear conscience. So the more you know, the better your analysis will be and the better decisions you'll make. So no need to hide under the couch. Use the net cash flows after taxes and then add to that any tax savings from non-cash items, and you'll make decisions that will help you as well as your company.